From Spider-Man to Batman to Catwoman to Armadillo Girl to Captain Diplodocus, lots of superheroes are themed after animals. But what if they were themed after the wrong animals? There are animals out there that are so strong, so tough, and have such long lives that they might just hold the key to immortality. These are the animals there should be superheroes of. These are animals that hold the key to immortality. Number 15. Bedeloids. Bedeloids have a pretty weird name, and they are a pretty weird microorganism. There are a lot of microorganisms in the world, like, seriously, a lot, and while no two are the same, it's fair to say that a lot of them are pretty darn similar. But bedeloids have some special abilities, which help them to stand out from the crowd. If these tiny creatures were a person, they would be some kind of Shaolin monk. They are seriously tough, and researchers discovered they haven't reproduced for 80 million years. So they are not expending their valuable energy on philandering. They get around this problem by stealing genetic material from other species so that they can keep updating themselves. They are also seriously tough and can survive some serious punishment. They live in water but often colonize small freshwater pools which dry up. Usually bad news for any water-dependent creature, but not for the bedeloid. They just take the brutal pounding of the sun and wait for a really long time until water comes back, all the while living out a no-sex policy like some religious maniac. They are incredibly resilient, which in most animals causes terrible damage to gene health, but the mysteries of their powers of resistance are still being uncovered. Like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Number 14. Red Sea Urchin. There's a lot of variety in sea urchins, but some species are incredibly long-lived, with lifespans of up to 200 years, and what's more, they don't seem to age, and nor do their reproductive ability ever slow. These urchins are in the mood for getting down right up until their old age. Although, with all those spikes, it's kinda surprising. Looks like it might be a little uncomfortable. It was previously thought that the red sea urchin only lived around 15 years, because they could never find individuals with signs of biological aging beyond this amount. But it turns out that while they get older, they never age. Which, correct me if I'm wrong, seems like a pretty important part of immortality. Imagine living for thousands of years, but you still keep getting older at the regular rate, looking like Gollum after a couple hundred years. And that would be just the beginning. But the sea urchins seem to have figured out how to live long and stay youthful. Scientists are continuing to work at unraveling the strange mystery of eternal youth in red sea urchins. Number 13. Naked Mole Rat. Unlike the other two species on this list so far, naked mole rats do experience something called senescence, which is pre-programmed cellular aging. But in these creepy-looking underground creatures, it works in a way which seems to promote incredible longevity and also helps them to avoid cancer, which is a cellular disease responsible for a huge amount of deaths among all species which have cellular aging. If these were a normal species, we would expect their lifespan to be around 6 years, similar to lab mice, who are around the same size. The naked, buck-toothed weirdos might look like they are already 100 years old, but they are literally the only mammal which does not age. When they die, it is due to random events, which can occur at any time, such as infection, predators, or starvation. In lab conditions, fed and protected, they just keep going and going. Rochelle Buffenstein, a senior researcher at a San Francisco lab, looking into these crazy animals, said, "It is our absolute belief that when we find out what these mechanisms are, they will give rise to inventions that could abrogate the aging process in humans." Pretty cool. Number 12. Bowhead Whales. Now it's time for the longest living mammal species, the bowhead whale. the oldest bowhead whales can live to an incredible 268 years, that means that there are bowhead whales likely living in our seas now who were born during the pioneer era, at a time when Benjamin Franklin was still experimenting with electricity and the US was a battleground for the massive seven-year war fought between Prussia and Britain on one side, and Austria, Russia, Sweden, France, and Saxony on the other. With a certain George Washington making his name as a great commander for the British, that's a long time ago in other words, it seems the bowhead has a gene which is linked to DNA repair and anti-cancer abilities, as well as genes which lower metabolism and so slow down the aging process. British and American scientists were first able to map this whale's genome in 2015, and now the race is on to understand some of its incredible anti-aging abilities. These massive mammals might hold some of the secrets we are looking for. Number 11. Giant tortoises. Another animal that was around while George Washington was still a teenager was Atueta, an Alapra giant tortoise who lived at the Alipore Zoological Gardens in Kolkata, India. Carbon dating of his shell showed he was first born around 1750, and when he finally passed away due to a cracked shell in 2006, he was more than 250 years old, and had been at the zoo since the 1870s. These giant tortoises do not age, and their organs at 100 years old are just the same as a young tortoise, which has just reached sexual maturity. They also keep breeding right up until the end, and usually only die due to infection, starvation, or predation. Even in the wild, they live to an average of more than 100 years, making them the longest living vertebrates in the world. Unfortunately, many other species of giant tortoise were driven to extinction by human hunters by the 1840s, but the Aldabra giant tortoise escaped due to living on a remote island atoll. Who knows what secrets we may have lost with those other species, but we can now do our best to save the endangered giant tortoises around the world, as they may have the answers to our own future. Number 10. Lobsters. Have you ever seen an old lobster? You know, gray beard, walking stick, things like that. Thought not. That's because this is another species which seems to have been spared the pains of aging. In fact, lobsters just keep growing larger and becoming more fertile as they age. If anything, they get younger and healthier as time goes on. One restaurant was hoping to serve up a huge 20-pound lobster to a hungry diner until activists pointed out that the crustacean was a 140-year-old miracle that probably deserved better than being served up as a side dish to a family bucket at Red Lobster. Our cells divide and copy so that we can keep going. But as this process continues through life, the cells run out of a kind of protective cap called telomeres. When a cell runs out of this, it stops dividing, and this causes slowing and aging in the organism. But lobsters have an endless supply of an enzyme called telomerase, which simply regenerates the telomeres, meaning that cells never run out. Humans also have this enzyme, but nowhere near enough to stop us from aging. One day, perhaps we will be able to increase how much of it we have and live long and prosper like the lobsters. Number 9. Glass sponges. That thing on the side of the bathtub that you use to wash yourself, that's one of the longest living animals known to man. I don't mean the washcloth, but the natural sponge. Sponges are living things that are basically immobile, feeding on filtered food particles which drift by in the seawater. They are able to completely reform their bodies so that they can attach themselves to rocks, which allows water and food to flow by them, without the sponge being washed away. In fact, they can remold themselves in incredible ways. You can take 5 sea sponges of different species and blast them in a blender, then pass them through a sieve, and once back in a natural saltwater environment, all 5 sponges will manage to sort out who is who and reform pretty much as they were. That's pretty amazing. And how long do these strange animals live? Well, as much as 11,000 years, according to one study of deep sea sponges. What kind of planet will we be living on when a deep sea sponge born today finally dies? Number 8. Hydra. There's a lot of talk in medicine these days about stem cells and how important they are going to be for the future. The Hydra is a small sea organism related to sea anemones and jellyfish that is made up of primarily stem cells and is able to continuously split itself, meaning that it is constantly regenerating and never ages. This discovery has led to particular interest from scientists in recent years as they look to unlock the possibilities of this species for anti-aging. After observing 2,000 hydras over 4 years, researchers found no signs of aging or mortality among these tiny predators. They have stinging cells and prey upon worms, larvae, and small crustaceans, and can even sting fish to death, in defiance if necessary. Maybe that would be another cool power we could borrow from them. Eternal life and huge, stinging tentacles. Imagine what a badass you would be. Another thing hydras can do is kind of the opposite to the sea sponge. If you cut a hydra up, it won't die. You'll just have 5 or 10 hydras, depending on how many pieces you chopped it into. Hence the name, after the ancient Greek monster which grew 2 heads every time you cut one off. Number 7. Ocean Quahog Clam. They're good in chowder and they also live an insanely long time. I'm talking clams. And the ocean quahog clam is one of the longest living species on Earth. Not to mention being the animal Peter Griffin's hometown is named after. One of these clams near Iceland was dated as being 405 years old and still going. Yeah, this clam was born back in the times when you could still be executed for witchcraft, and being hanged, drawn, and quartered was a regular punishment for criminals. Even regular clams of this kind live in excess of 200 years, and they never stop growing. Once reaching a certain size, they usually burrow down into the ocean floor, where they are largely protected from predators. And down there, they just hang out, feed on algae, reproduce from time to time, and live for hundreds of years until someone decides to haul them out to make clam chowder. If you ever find one of these, you can tell the age of it by the growth rings which appear on the shell. And some of them must have a hell of a lot of rings by now. Number 6. Jellyfish. Teratopsis dohrnii are tiny jellyfish that can completely reverse the process of aging. If the jellyfish falls sick or is injured, it can activate an insane special power which allows it to return to what is known as the polyp stage, basically back to its youngest self. It takes 3 days to make the transformation, and then the jellyfish can start its life all over again. Going through those jellyfish teenage years time after time is probably not that much fun, at least not for its jellyfish parents, but then hey, they can just press reset whenever they like to. There seems to be no limit to how many times this jellyfish can perform this incredible trick, meaning that this creature is basically immortal unless it's eaten by something. Research into this amazing species is only just beginning, and it has so far not been possible to create the right lab conditions for close study. But the mechanism is being unlocked already. They are pretty small though, measuring less than 0.2 of an inch, so if you want to catch one and figure it out for yourself, you will need a hawk-like vision just to find one. Number 5. Water bear bugs. We know them as water bears, scientists know them as tardigrades, and everyone knows them as one of the weirdest living things ever discovered. Life is not supposed to work like this, but these tiny creatures prove that there really aren't any rules. When people get all worked up about us wiping out all life on Earth through pollution or nuclear war or whatever, water bears just laugh. They can survive boiling water, they can be frozen, they can live in the vacuum of space. You can dry them out completely, leave them for years and years, then splash them with water and again, they get up and carry on as though nothing happened. They do this by covering themselves in molecules of glass, and now researchers are looking into how this could change glass forever. Water bears are pretty crazy looking, like a piglet crossed with an evil-faced Michelin man. They have 8 legs and live everywhere from inside volcanoes to the deep sea, to the Antarctic, to rainforests. They're about 0.5 millimeter long and first evolved 500 million years ago. Harnessing some of their incredible resilience might be the key to eternal life. Number 4. Rough-eye rockfish. The rough-eye rockfish is thought to be the longest living fish in the world, being capable of ages in excess of 200 years. They can grow to almost 40 inches and weigh over 14 pounds, and their range extends from San Diego to the Aleutian Islands and Bering Sea to the Kamchatka Peninsula and Japan. Similar to the lobsters, clams, and naked mole rats, they have managed to avoid aging, at least until the very end of their long lives. Cells are powered by mitochondria, and these generate chemical energy stores, which allow cells to do their work. Mitochondria are descended from bacteria and still contain bacterial DNA. Damage to mitochondria leads to a complex series of events, which results in mitochondria taking over cells. If the mitochondria DNA is damaged, either by radiation or just wear over time. In rockfish, the mitochondria DNA does not seem to suffer the same amount of damage as other similar species, and this gives these fish the rare key to immortality. Number 3. Planarian worms. Planarian flatworms are a pretty hilarious-looking species with a cross-eyed appearance that is instantly endearing. But there's more to these worms than that, as they can defy death by constant regeneration, a fact which has excited many scientists and researchers. If you cut one of these worms in half, from the top to bottom, you will soon have two worms. Cut them cross-halfwise, and you will have four. And you can keep doing that until you have like a million planarian worms, I guess. The way they do this is due to stem cells, which are triggered by the injury and set out right away to rebuild the necessary organs for the new worm, including its pair of cross eyes. Regeneration happens in all species to some extent. A human body can heal from minor wounds, a starfish can grow back a lost leg, but this is an extreme example which has opened a wide range of possibilities for the future of stem cell research and may hold one of the keys to immortality. Number 2. Sea anemone. These prickly little balls certainly don't look much like animals, but that's exactly what they are. And they don't age like other animals either, growing bigger and bigger indefinitely and never aging. They usually live around 80 years, since this is the average amount of time they can keep going until they are killed by heat, water pollution, humans, or infections. But otherwise, they would be able to keep going forever. And they have stinging cells, which they use for defense and to catch prey. They are predators. They usually attach themselves to rocks underwater, but some species prefer to bury themselves in sand or mud or gravel. They reproduce in a variety of ways, sexually like humans, or sometimes they break off a small chunk of themselves, which then grows into a new anemone. Some species prefer to grow bigger and then split in half to create two new individuals of equal size. Yes, another incredible species, which will be important as we continue our adventure toward biological immortality. Number 1. The giant pyrosome. The giant pyrosome is an organism which is both hermaphroditic, meaning it has male and female genitalia, and is able to clone itself, which is pretty cool. How about being able to make your own clone to go out to work for you? These amazing creatures can grow, shrink, reproduce, and regenerate at will, making them one of the best adapted for potential immortality. They are free-floating tunicates, which can grow 60 feet in length and be wide enough for a person to swim through. They constantly filter water through, which is how they gain food, flush waste, and propel themselves. In fact, the creature is made up of thousands of clones who all do this job together, contributing to the whole organism, and it will keep cloning itself as much as it needs to. They are also bioluminescent, meaning they produce their own light. Pyrosome means fire body in ancient Greek, and if I'm getting immortality, I totally want the ability to produce fire as well. If the organism is attacked, as long as one clone remains, it will be able to rebuild itself, meaning it can pretty much live forever. Would you like to live forever? What would you do for the rest of eternity? Let us know in the comments below. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!